these people come up off the ground. You know what I'm saying?
So see how good your legs work.
Feel free to just do whatever, but don't get hurt.
Thank you.
You just don't know what's going to happen. The next day, just everything in your life could change. So that's why it's so important to be thankful every day. Is everybody thankful here tonight? The song is called More of This Life.
Thank you.
We're so glad to be here in Ron's home city of Detroit. What up? Detroit World Outreach, this place is awesome. We're from Florida, so we're actually far away from our homeland. But like I said, we're really excited to be here. We've been on the road with Matthew West and Paul Wright. I don't know if you guys ever heard of those guys. If you haven't, you need to pick up their album. It's great. But
even though we're far from home right now, you guys are definitely making us feel right at home here.
That's right.
Pastor Sherry said, you gotta play that song again.
What song?
You gotta play my favorite song. She was about to knock me on the ground if I didn't play this song. So this one goes to Pastor Sherry. The song is called Off the Ground.
Thank you.
people. There's somebody that is always there with you. Amen?
Yeah.
Amen. It's God, and He loves us so much, and we just want to share this message with you. So whenever you think you are discouraged, don't get discouraged. Just look, instead of looking inward, look upward. Amen? Is that cool? Yeah. All right. So we're going to sing this song for you, and Lou's going to play the bass, and I'm going to play the keys like I always did when I was here at church. Is that cool? You guys are just incredible. Incredible. You guys are the greatest church in America. I love you so much. It almost makes me want to move back to the snow, but there it is now.
Well, let me readjust my microphone stand since I keep a nice one up here. Right, I don't know. But yeah, like you said, this song's called You're Not Alone, so sing along if you want. Of course, it's real easy, it's just You're Not Alone. That's it.
I see your soul.
chunky stone. I'm seeing less and less more people up here. I see some holes that need to be filled. So if anybody left, if you could just scoot up a little bit more, we can get a little closer. Just get as close to you. Y'all are still wanting to rock out your home set. We thank you guys. Well, not necessarily on the steps, but you know what I'm saying. Close. This next song right here is called Dance to Me. It's a very beautiful song. The song's about absence.
I'm getting him back because he always calls me Biggin. Everything that we're talking about, totally with Coleman when Pastor Therese comes up. You guys gotta make sure you listen to that after we get done playing. Is that cool?
You gotta get fed tonight.
And here's what we need to do. You guys gotta get on your feet. This is our last song. It's our single. We're sitting in my hometown of Detroit.
Guess you don't have the internet here, but it's fucking. But this last one is our single. If you go on iTunes, you can buy it for 99 cents. But we're gonna need to see everybody jump in on this song. Is that alright?
Let's see how good your legs work on this one. You guys ready?
This one's called Miracle.
Thank you.
freeze right where you are. I want everybody to close their eyes right now. Because tonight, they didn't just sing, they ministered in song. And even though it was not maybe what you're used to as far as ministry in song, but they ministered in song tonight. And if you really listen to the words that they said, the things that they talked about were not a religion. They talked about a relationship. They talked specifically about a relationship, and actually a deeper relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. They didn't just talk about surface things, stuff all on the outside, you know, kind of standing far back away from God. They talked about moving in. They talked about things that only you can talk about when you actually have an intimate relationship with Him. And so right now, I want you to just close your eyes, and I want you to just ask yourself right now, do I have an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ right now? Do I have a relationship with Him where I feel like I can just come to Him and talk to Him, just like they just ministered to you? I can just talk to Jesus. Do I have that intimate relationship with Him? Or does He seem far away? You know that song, you know, Never Alone? It was really interesting because, and it was so true, many times we feel alone, but just as the words in the song said, you know, not only will God never leave you or forsake you, but you are not alone. You are absolutely not alone. And so tonight, I want to give you an opportunity tonight to do just as you've heard, just the collage of song that you heard tonight. I want you to just take the time just for a moment and just ask yourself, do I really, really know Jesus? Do I really know Him? And if you don't, you have an opportunity right now to get that chance to know Him. And so with every head bowed, every eyes, everybody's eyes closed, I want you to raise your hand tonight. If you say, you know what, I thought I had a relationship with Him, but the things they're talking about up here, you know, a miracle, you know, and they're talking about abstinence and, you know, really, really, really making Jesus number one in your life and these types of things, you know, I really don't know if I'm that close to Him. And so right now, again, I just want you to just search inside of yourself, and if you can not answer the question in your heart, but if today was your very last day on this planet, that you know that you know that you know beyond a shadow of a doubt that you would go home to be with the Lord, I want you to raise your hand right now. You may have, amen, I see one, amen, two, three, four, amen, five, when you, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I mean, it's just keep raising your hand. If the Lord is speaking to you right now, I know He's touching your heart because the atmosphere is totally charged with His presence. And so right now, you know, you may have made up in your heart, no, I don't really know if I know Him. But then there's some of you in here that do know Him, that absolutely know Him. But maybe you kind of like, you know, left Him for a little while, kind of like backed away from Him for a little while because you kind of went to do your own thing. Well, I believe that the words and these songs tonight were pulling you closer to Him. And so if there are those of you in this room tonight, before we pray, you know, the first prayer, I want to ask you for this second appeal. If you want to rededicate your life to the Lord tonight, you say, Lord, you know what? I'm not sure if I have that deep relationship or not. I'm not really sure if I know Him like I think they were kind of talking about in the songs. If you want to know Him and have a deeper relationship with Him, you were talking about intimacy, where you can really get to know Him in your heart and you can really speak out and talk out to Him. If you want to rededicate your life tonight, I want you to raise your hand as well. I just want you to raise your hand. Amen. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Is there anybody else? When you say, you know, I just want to rededicate my life. I kind of want to, like, start it all over again. You know, it was awesome they sing that song, Miracle. You know, it's right. His hand's like, look, you know what? just flows out of me. And so if there's anyone else, amen, there's more who say, you know what, I just want to, many of you are already giving your lives to the Lord, but you say, you know, only become more serious about it. Being serious and having fun, you can do both at the same time. And so you know what, I want to be more serious about Him in my own life, and I'm still going to have a whole lot of fun. I'm still going to have a whole lot of fun, but I want to be a little more serious about it. I don't want to take it as something lightly. Jesus is much more than that to me, and I really believe that. And so if you've come forward right now, I just want everyone behind you to just stretch out your hands, and we're just going to pray a prayer right now. Amen. Amen. We're going to pray one more prayer. For those of you who said, you know, I want to give you an opportunity even more to come forth if you feel like, hey, you know what? I need to rededicate my life to the Lord. I've already given my life to Him, but you know what? I need to rededicate. I need to become a little more serious and really, really spend some time that I haven't spent with Him before. I know I can pray more. My sisters and brothers, I can talk a little differently. And so if that's you, again, I'm going to give you an opportunity for a moment to go ahead and come forward, and then we're going to pray. So is there anybody else who says, you know what, I want to rededicate my life to the Lord. I want to get a little more serious this time. Still having fun, but I want to become a little more serious about the things of God right now. Amen. If that's you, go ahead and come forward right now. And as you come forward, I want everyone to close their eyes again. And I want you to repeat after me. Say, Father, I belong to You. You are my Lord. And You are my Savior. Lord, I want to hear You as I've never heard You before. Lord, I want to speak to You as I've never spoken to You before. Lord God, Lord, come into my life at a new level, at a deeper level, so that I can commune with You and have an intimate relationship with You.
We'll keep praying for you guys every step of your way. It's going to be glorious. Amen.
All right.